Coach Harper. Coach, after the way some of the end of games have gone here down the stretch, to close one out that way at home, how nice was that?
Well, I mean, you know, it's two in a row we've closed out. St. Joe's last Thursday, Thanksgiving Day, and then again tonight. Kids compete, man. They play hard. Just made some good decisions with the basketball. Ben stepped up, made some free throws, and great basketball game. One of those grinded out games, which we knew it was going to be. It's how they like to play. And I think we're the second team that's played them that scored 60 or more. Everyone else, they've held them to 50. So we had some great looks, didn't go down. But we were able to hold them to 34%, you know, field goal percentage shooting. So a lot of positives, especially on the defensive end for us.
Holmes was ineffective pretty much across the board. How were you guys able to neutralize him so well tonight?
Well, he got a lot of attention. I mean, Ben's 7'1 with a 7'5 wingspan. And Ben did a great job of not getting angled in the post, making him score over him. And you know, Holmes is 6'8", he's 7'1", and when he raises his arms, that's a tough shot for him. And, you know, George and Justin were active off the ball, got some block shots. We didn't let him get comfortable. And we've had a tendency with some post guys early on in the season where we didn't do our work early and let him catch the ball too deep in the post. We didn't do that tonight. We did our work early and got him out of his comfort zone, and, you know, I think a lot credit goes a lot to Ben, but it's a team effort. And guards did a pretty good job keeping ball pressure, not making it an easy pass. So there's a lot of things, but he's a heck of a player. I just thought we did a good job on him.
George led the team in points and blocks. Did you say anything to him before this game?
Did I say anything to him?
Yeah.
I just told him how much we needed him, this afternoon. I tell him that every day. Sometimes he listens. Really well. He listened tonight. But now George is, you know, he's getting back to his old self. I thought he was active. Late in the game, we made better decisions with our passes. We had a stretch where we just make some careless passes. And we just got to continue to watch film and drill it, play off 2 feet, pass fake. And we did some of it, don't get me wrong, but we still got to get better. That's the biggest area of concern for me right now is the turnovers and trying to get those corrected.
How big were those games from George and Ben when you shoot 3 of 17?
We haven't shot it great from the three recently. We made three, and two of those were bang bang by Trincy right there in the second half. But I think we're a team that can play and not make a lot of threes and still be okay. We got George in there. Ben's a guy. We've got to turn him loose and let him shoot that 3-pointer right there at the top of the key. And tomorrow we're gonna talk a lot about that. If they're gonna let him have that, he can shoot it. And I think he's a little. I don't know if I want to shoot that. Coach might get mad, but I'm gonna shoot that. If they're gonna back off, turn it loose, let it go, and see, or take one step in and shoot the 17-footer. But again, Ben's only been playing for 3 years, but sometimes when you watch him, it's like, wow, he's got a bright future. Well, the thing that George does, he draws a lot of attention, and he may not score, but he's going to make the game easier for all the other guys because he draws so much attention. He did again tonight. I think when I look at Chris and TJ and Nigel and those guys, they're good shooters, and they're going to make shots. You know, they didn't tonight, but I'm comfortable with them shooting the basketball at any time. And it's just right now we haven't clicked on all cylinders on the offensive end. I think we will, but most important thing to me is if you're going to win games going forward, you have to do two things. You've got to defend, and you have to rebound. If you do those two things, you can have nights like tonight where you don't shoot the ball well and you can still win. And that's kind of our MO is we want to be – it's the last thing that we talk about before we leave the locker room, defense and rebounding. And let the defense dictate your offense. And, you know, hopefully we can continue to do that.
Anybody, a couple more? Coach, two big games now, one back-to-back. How do you prepare for Murray State, big rivalry game this weekend?
we'll watch film with coaching staff in the morning, get with Coach Forrest, it's his scout, and we'll talk about some things for practice tomorrow. Again, we approach every game the same, and I know some people, coaches say that, but we do. It doesn't matter if it's an NCAA tournament game or first round of the conference. We don't put any more emphasis on one game than we do the next. I think anytime you do that, kids sense it. And it's the next game on the schedule, so it's the biggest game of the year. Once that's over, whomever we have next, I don't know who it is, but they'll be the biggest game on the schedule. But we've got some areas we got to get better, and we got to get in the gym tomorrow and try to fix those. Yeah, they returned all five starters, and then they got that Seymour kid that transferred from Utah, who's a terrific player. They got a JUCO kid inside. Just got a kid cleared eligible maybe a week ago, a 6'7" inside kid. I think they're a little bit like us, kind of trying to find themselves on the offensive end. But you know, they were terrific, 120 whatever last year, and they returned all five starters. So I think it's an indication that just because you have a lot of guys back, it still may take some time. And but they're a good basketball team. They always play well at home, and I know this is a game they're looking forward to, but so are we.
All right. Thank you, everybody.
All right.
Thanks, Coach.